Okay, here's my second video over dilations, and this time we're going to dilate from a center that is not the origin. So we're going to find some other point on the graph and dilate from there. So in example one, we're dilating triangle ABC that has these vertices and a center of dilation here. So not at the origin, but some other center of dilation, and it gives us our scale factor of 3, and we want to find the coordinates of the image. Well, let me start by plotting the original. 1, negative 1 is there. 3, 1 is there, and 4, negative 1 is there. So these are my original figure, okay? Now what this says is we're going to use a center of dilation of 2, negative 2. So I want to plot that center of dilation right there. Now I'm going to do that in green so we can kind of see it right there. But that's our center of dilation. And for this, there's not really an algorithm. I can't just take these coordinates and multiply by my scale factor like we did in our previous example when we dilated from the origin. Since we're dialing from a different point, I can't just multiply that. And there's not like a calculation that you can make. You basically just have to go off the graph. And here's what I mean by that. Let's start with to get from our center of dilation to A. I go up one and to the left one. So what I know is that my new figure is going to be 3 times as big because that's my scale factor. So if I go up 1, then I need to go up 2 and up 3. So basically, however I got from my center of dilation to A, I'm going to do that a total of 3 times to get to A prime. Now let's do the same thing for point B. To get from my center of dilation to point B, I go up 1, 2, 3 over 1. So that would be a scale factor of 1, and then we're going to do a scale factor of 2, rise 3, run 1, and then we need a scale factor of 3, rise 3, run 1. So that's my B prime. And then we're going to do the same thing for C. To get from my center of dilation to C, I rise 1, run 2. So that would be a scale factor of 1. That would preserve the original image. I want to do that 2 more times, so rise 1, run 2, rise 1, run 2. That's going to be C prime. So my new figure, A prime, B prime, C prime, is going to be this figure right here. I'll make that so you can see it. So just like any dilation, my image should be similar to my pre-image, meaning it's the same shape but different size. But remember, here we can't just multiply each of these coordinates by 3. I have to actually count up and over on my graph because we're dilating from a point other than the center. Now here's our second example, and this one's a little bit tricky. It says, given the triangle DEF and D prime E prime F prime, it's giving us the original or the pre-image and the image. It wants us to find the scale factor and the center of dilation. So let's start by plotting all these. D is negative 2, 3. E is 0, 3, and F is 1, 2. So this is my pre-image. Now let's plot the image, 0, 1, F is 4, 1, and, E is 4, 1, and F is 6, negative 1. So here's my image. Okay, so one thing I want us to realize is, let's remember back to our example here. An analogy that I make is, it's like we're doing hand puppets, meaning that here's my flashlight at the center of dilation, and if I hold my hand up here, it's going to broadcast that shadow on the wall this way. So that's the analogy I try to make. So if we're doing that same thing here, let's think about it. That means that the flashlight would have to be somewhere over here. And if this pre-image was your hand making the shape of the little rabbit or something, it would broadcast it on the wall over here. Okay? So let's look. How did I get from here to here? How did I get from the pre-image to the image? It looks like we went over 2 and down 2. Well, if I do that again and go up 2 and over 2, we'd be right there, wouldn't we? Then let's do the same thing with this other point. To get from point E from my pre-image to my image, I went over 1, 2, three, four, and down two. So let's kind of backtrack and do that same thing, and oh, look, we're ending up at the same spot. And if we did the same thing for point F, I went from here to here, from my preimage to my image. It looks like we went over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and down 3. So let's kind of go backwards, up 3 over 5, up 3 over 5. Well, you can see that we always end up at this point right here. So this is our center of dilation. So our center of dilation is going to be negative 4, 5. And then our scale factor, well, we can see that from our center of dilation to here, that would just be a scale factor of 1, because that's from the center of dilation to the pre-image. And it looks like we did that one time, two times. For each point, we did whatever that scale factor was, or we did this process twice. So that means our scale factor is 2. A way you could check it is just cover up your image and see how you got from your center of dilation to your pre-image, and do that again to get your scale factor of 2 and make sure it makes this figure. And you would see that it works. And so these problems are tricky because there's not an algorithm that you can memorize. There's not a simple three-step process where you can just plug in numbers and find your answer. You have to get on the graph paper, you have to work it out, you have to know what the process is and use some logic. So main thing to remember is just to graph it. We cannot just multiply our coordinates by the scale factor when our center is not the origin.